and tourism industry, both in private and public sector. He also has worked as the research and international relations and standards and quality assurance of Sri Lanka Tourism Development Authority. He has also served as the managing director of Sri Lanka Tourism Promotion Bureau from 2010 to 2011. He also held positions as the director, research and international relations, director, marketing and the director, corporate service of Sri Lankan Tourist Board. And today he will enlighten us about sustainable tourism. So, sir, the now stage is yours.
Mr. Sampatha Bevirama, director of the Kari Conference and also the organizing team. And the researchers who have come from many countries, ladies and gentlemen. IBOAN is the way that Sri Lanka traditionally welcome all of you. To say, may you live long with happy life. So I'm pleased to be here in this morning for the keynote speech on sustainable tourism, a catalyst for socio-economic and environmental development. So I thank the organizers for inviting me for this conference. I trust all international participants are enjoying your stay in Sri Lanka. So welcome all of you to Sri Lanka from world over. So we are very happy to be part with you in this morning. So tourism is today third largest export industry world after chemicals and fuels. It brings hope, prosperity and understanding to so many lives and livelihoods all over the world. Last year alone, 1.235 million travelers crossed international borders in one single year. By 2030, this 1.2 billion will become 1.8 billion. What does it mean by sustainable tourism? Sustainability principles refer to the environmental, economic and social aspects of tourism development, and a suitable balance must be established between these three dimensions to guarantee long-term sustainability. As you are aware, we are in the International Year of Sustainable Tourism for Development, which is a clear recognition of tourism contribution to the development agenda and to raise awareness of the potential of the sector to lead economic growth, social inclusion, and cultural and environmental preservation. Some hotels, resorts, tourist parks around the world have already initiated projects in community education and business education, carbon reduction, eradication of carbon footprint, social power, water management, recycle, reuse and minimize waste, pest and weed abatement and management. Not only hotels, but also some tour operators in the world practice sustainable measures including eco tours and fiber tours, etc. Now let me focus on Sri Lanka. Now, Sri Lanka is a being a country is endowed with flora and fauna and a rich cultural heritage. So this picture shows how enriching us in many fauna and flora as well as cultural heritage. The benefits of sustainability tourism will further pave way to boost the industry. The opportunities and benefits of sustainable tourism are threefold. Socially, the benefits such as social inclusiveness, employment and poverty reduction and alleviation, preserving of cultural values and intercultural understanding and tolerance are achievable by complying to sustainable tourism. In 2016, employment generation in tourism sector both direct and indirect was 335,659. Therefore, by adopting sustainable tourism, this amount can be further increased and it will pave way to poverty reduction too. Plans are already underway to develop new locations in Sri Lanka to minimize the pressure on popular tourist destinations. In the long term, such initiatives will contribute to the social, economic and environmental well-being and development. In the economy, inclusive and sustainable economic growth fairly distributed among all stakeholders and will be the ultimate benefits. During the last few years, Sri Lanka recorded a steady economic growth rate and a flourishing tourism industry. This can be further improved. As I showed earlier in my slide, there are so many potential in Sri Lanka. In 2016, total foreign exchange earnings from tourism was ₹512,000 million. However, steps should be taken to ensure fair distribution of benefits to all. So in terms of environment, the steps towards sustainability will ensure the optimal use of environmental resources, maintain ecological pressures, and help to conserve natural heritage and biodiversity. For example, some of the hotels in Sri Lanka have been rated as eco-friendly hotels by popular travel websites. Some hotels in Sri Lanka use cleaner production technologies to increase productivity and sustainability. These include the introduction of renewable alternative energy resources such as biomass, solar power for hot water. Also, these hotels have initiated projects to minimize solid waste, air pollution and other chemical pollution, minimize practices of reducing recycling and minimize use of environmentally friendly materials, maximize indigenous flora in landscaping, conserve biodiversity and support local livelihoods. Further, the innovations waveless boats, which ensures environmental protection, are some of the initial steps of sustainable tourism in Sri Lanka. All these steps will pave the way to optimal use of environmental resources while conserving it. Since Rio+20, the blue economy has gained momentum across the globe. And Sri Lanka being an island covered with the Indian Ocean, the need to stimulate a blue growth is greatly felt. Living in a blue planet with over 70% of the Earth's surface covered by the ocean and seas, it is important to include it as a new economic frontier and a new source of industrialization and growth.